Good morning, students. This is Sudhakar, lecturer in mathematics, Government Arts College, Rajahmundry. In the last class, we have discussed what is binary operation and some fundamentals and what is group. Now, I am going to tell about some examples on groups. Right? So for this we need, what are the number systems? You know very well, what are the natural numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, like this. What are the whole numbers? 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. What are the integers? Positive numbers, negative numbers, including zero. Right? These are the integers. What is the rational number? So it is of the form P by Q. Here Q not equal to zero. If Q equal to zero, then P by zero undefined. So that's why Q not equal to zero. And one more, P comma, the GCD of P comma equal to one. GCD of P comma Q equal to 1. Next, what is irrational? It is not a rational. For example, square root 2, square root 3, square root 5, like this. Next, what are real numbers? So the union of rational and irrationals. What are the complex? Complex numbers. C equal to the elements is of the form A plus or minus I by AB, where A comma B belongs to real numbers, where I square equal to minus 1. Understand? So N is the natural number, W is a whole numbers, Z represents integers, rationals, irrationals, real numbers, complex numbers. These are the number systems, right? Now, next. So, examples of a group. So, Z plus, Q plus, R plus, C plus. These four are examples of groups. Now, verify one by one. Z plus is a group. What is Z? So, 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Negative integers, positive integers, including 0. This is Z. Set of all integers. Now we verify Z under plus. Z under plus, is it group or not? So here what is the operation? Addition. Addition is the binary operation. Right? So here the operation addition satisfies the closure property, associative, existence of identity, and last but not least, existence of inverse. Then we say that Z under plus is a group. Coming to first property. So closure property. What is the property? Take any element, two elements in G. That is A comma B belongs to G. So A star B is also belongs to G. For all A comma B belongs to G. So I take A equal to B equal to 3. What is A star B? What is A? 2. What is B? 3. What is star? Addition. 2 plus 3. How much? 5. So 5 is an integer. Clearly. Not only these two elements. A equal to 2, B equal to 3. You take any elements. in the set. A equal to minus 2, B equal to minus 1. So what is A plus B? So minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. Minus 3 is also an integer. Integers. So take any two elements in Z, add those numbers. That is also belongs to Z. So A comma B belongs to Z. That implies A star B is also belongs to G for all A comma B comma. So A comma B belongs to Z. So therefore here star is closure. Star satisfies the closure property. Understand? Second property. Next. Associative. So here I take three elements. What is the property? A star of B star C equal to A star B of star C for all A comma B comma C belongs to G. I take A equal to 1, B equal to 2, C equal to 3. Replace. So this is the relation. Take LHS. A plus of B plus C. What is A? 1. What is A? 1. What is B? 2. What is C? 3. Now simplify first these two in brackets. What is 2 plus 3? 5. So again, what is 1 plus 5? LHS. This is 1. Coming to RHS. What is A? 1. What is B? 2. What is C? 3. Simplify first these two in brackets. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 plus 3, 6. Therefore, LHS, 6. RHS, 6. Therefore, both are same. Therefore, LHS equal to RHS, star satisfies associative. You take any elements, not only these three elements, you verify this relation, right? Then this property always holds when the operation is addition, only addition. Coming to next property. Existence of identity. So in this property you find identity value. So what is the property? Let A belongs to G. For all A belongs to G, there exists an identity element E belongs to G such that A star E equal to E star A equal to A. This is the property. Already in previous class we learn, right? Here A is an identity element. You find E value, right? So I take A equal to, what is the property? A star E equal to A. Second relation, E star A equal to A. What is A star? Take this relation. What is A? 2. 2. What is star plus E equal to, what is again? It is again A. Nothing but E equal to 2 minus 2. That is 0. 0 belongs to Z, right? This is for this relation. E plus A, what is A? 2 is again 2. So 2 minus 2, 0. This is right identity. This is left identity. Therefore, both are exist. Therefore, what is the identity element? Element E equal to 0. Clearly 0 belongs to Z. Therefore identity element is exist. What is the identity element? 0. Now using this identity element you find inverse of all elements in G. Next, right? What is the property? Let A belongs to G. So for all A belongs to G, there exists an element B belongs to G such that A star B equal to B star A equal to E. That is, here B is called inverse of A. You find B value because B is inverse of A. Right? What is the relation? A star B, you take any relation B from these two. You find B value. So replace, what is A value? What is the operation? Plus B. What is the E value? 0. Right? therefore 2 plus b equal to 0, b equal to 0 minus 2, so minus 2 is belongs to Z. Suppose minus 2 not belongs to Z, then the inverse of A does not exist. But here clearly minus 2 belongs to Z, therefore minus 2 is the additive inverse of 2. Therefore, you take any element. So suppose A equal to 3. What is the inverse? Minus 3. Suppose you take A equal to 4. What is the inverse? Additive inverse? Minus 4. Therefore, all the elements in G have unique inverse. Therefore, all the properties are satisfied. Therefore, Z plus is a group. Z plus is a group. Similarly, we can say that Q plus R plus C plus. Similarly, Q plus R plus C plus. These are all examples of groups. These are all examples of groups. Now coming to next one. Now I want to give an examples which are not a group. First one, N plus is not a group. Why? Because identity element does not exist. Right? So I give here clarification. What is identity property? For all A belongs to G, there exists E belongs to G, such that A star E equal to E star A equal to A. Right? Here E is called identity element. Right? Suppose you take A equal to 2. And what is the operation here? Star plus. So A star E equal to A. What is A? 2. What is star addition? E equal to. It is again A. 2. Therefore, E equal to 2 minus 2. What is the value? 0. 0 does not belong to N. Therefore, identity element does not exist. So, that's why N plus is not a group. This is the only one reason it is not a group. Right? Understand? A star E equal to A. Here A, I take A equal to. So A star E equal to A. A plus E equal to A. Therefore 2 plus E equal to. That is E equal to 0. Does not belongs to N. Identity element does not exist in N. Next example. N dot is also not a group. Why? Here inverse does not exist. Here operation change. What is the operation? Dot. Nothing but multiplication. What is the property? For all A belongs to G, there exists an element B belongs to G, such that A star B equal to B star A equal to A. You find here B value because B is the inverse of A. What is the multiplicative identity with respect to dot? 1. With respect to addition? 0. Right? With respect to multiplication, identity element is 1. With respect to addition, multiplication 0 is the identity element. Yeah. Right? Now A star B. So take A equal to 2. So star dot is in the place of star. Therefore A equal to 2 dot B equal to E. What is E in N dot? So what is the multiplicative identity? 1. So E equal to 1. Therefore what is B value? 1 by 2. 1 by 2 is it belongs to N? No. Why? 1 by 2 is a rational number, not a natural number. Therefore inverse does not exist. Therefore 2 into b equal to 1, b equal to 1 by 2, 1 by 2 does not belongs to n, therefore inverse does not exist. Next, now coming to w plus, same as above, because it is also not a group, why inverse does not exist. So for all a belongs to b, there exists b belongs to g, such that a star b equal to b star a equal to e. That is a star b equal to, you find b value, b is the inverse of a. I take a again, a equal to 2. What is the star? Plus 2 plus b equal to, so what is the additive entity? 0. So b equal to 0 minus 2. That is nothing but minus 2. Minus 2 is belongs to w? No. It is a negative integer. So it is not belongs to w. Therefore, here inverse does not exist. Understand? Next. Now this time w dot, why it is not a group? Inverse does not exist. Same. For all a belongs to g, there exists b belongs to g, this property. Right? So you find b value, a star b equal to e. I take a equal to, again, 2. What is the operation? Dot b equal to, what is the multiplicative identity? 1. Therefore, b equal to 1 by 2. 1 by 2 belongs to w? No, 1 by 2 is a rational number, not a natural, not a whole number. Therefore, here also, inverse does not exist. Therefore, w comma dot is not a group. Students, understand? Next, coming to z dot is not a group, right? So here, what is the, why? Because inverse does not exist. So same property, this is inverse property, you know. Here B is called inverse of A. So I take this relation, A star B equal to A. I take A equal to 3. So now A star B equal to E, this is the property. What is A value? 3. What is the star here? Dot. 3 dot B equal to, what is the multiplicative identity? 1. B, again B equal to 1 by 3. 1 by 3 is belongs to Z? No. 1 by 3 is a rational number, not an integer. Therefore, here, inverse does not exist. Next, coming to Q dot. So, Q dot is not a group because only one element has no inverse, that is zero. So this is the property of inverse, right? Here B is called inverse of A. So take relation A star B equal to A. I take A equal to 0. You find inverse of A, right? So what is the property? A star B equal to E. Take A equal to 0. What is star? Dot. What is E? 1. Why? So 1 is the multiplicative identity. Therefore B equal to 1 by 0. Which is undefined. Therefore, here 0 has no inverse. That is the only one reason due to Q comma dot is not a group. So 0 into b equal to 1, b equal to 1 by 0, which is undefined. Therefore, 0 has no inverse in Q. Coming to next, now R dot, same, here also same reason, 0 has no inverse in R, this is the inverse property, right? Here B is called inverse of A. I take this relation, same, so A star B equal to E, 0, what is star? Dot, what is B? Is it B? B is same as what is E? 1. 1 is the multiplicative identity. Therefore, B equal to 1 by 0, which is also undefined. Therefore, inverse does not exist in R comma dot. Right? Next. R comma dot. Next. So here you observe one thing, Q dot R dot. These are examples of these two are not a group. Why? 0 has no inverse. Except 0, for example, except 0. This is a group with respect to multiplication. So here R, so R minus singleton 0. So we domain launch mirror chestunnaru 0 ni eliminate chestunnaru. Then we say that Q comma dot is a group. Right? Next. Now coming to next. Abelian property or commutative. What is abelian group? A group G comma star is said to be an abelian if A star B equal to B star A. For all A comma B belongs to G. What is the property? A star B equal to B star A. For all A comma B belongs to G, then the given group is called an abelian. An abelian. So now take examples of groups Z plus, Q plus, R plus, C plus. Verify, is it Z plus is abelian or not? What is the property? A star B equal to B star A. A star B equal to B star A. Verify Z plus. Take A equal to 2, B equal to 3. What is LHS? A star B. What is A? 2. What is B? 3. What is star? Operation. Plus. What is 2 plus 3? 5. Similarly, what is RHS? B star A. What is B? 3. What is A? 2. What is the value? 5. Therefore, LHS equal to RHS. Therefore, Z plus is an abelian. Similarly, Q plus, R plus, C plus are also, these are all abelian groups. These are all abelian groups. So Q plus, similarly we can say that Q plus, R plus, C plus are examples of, are abelian groups. Next. So now what next definition? What is groupoid? Here star satisfies only closure property. Then we say that this algebraic structure is called groupoid. Understand? If star satisfies only one property, then we say that G comma semicircle or G comma star, whatever it may be, it is a groupoid. What is the example? N plus. Because closure property satisfies in N. Next. What is semigroup? Here star satisfies closure associative. Then S under star, here S is a non-empty set, star is an operation, star satisfies the closure and associative. If star satisfies these two, closure associative, then it is semigroup. Examples N plus, because here addition satisfies the closure property, associative property in N. Right? Next, monoid. So what is monoid? Let M be an unempty set. If star satisfies the properties closer associated to existence of identity, the operation star is satisfies closer associated to inverse. I'm sorry. Closer associated to identity. I repeat once again. Star satisfies closer associated to identity. Then here M comma star is a monoid. Example N dot W under addition, W under dot Z under plus. Already we discussed just now, right? Next. Now finally, applications of group theory. Students, the number of applications of group theory in use in the different fields, so the those are biology, physics, chemistry, etc. right. See students, these are the examples of group, and also we discussed those which is not examples of groups, right? And next, what is abelian, what is groupoid, what is monoid, what is semigroup. Understand? Okay students, see you in the next class. Thank you.